Hello everyone, my name is Mansi Anand and today we're going to study about marketing. So let's start. So first of all, let us start by understanding the meaning of marketing. So what is marketing? I think the simplest definition that we can assign to marketing is identifying and meeting human and social needs. So basically what a marketer has to do, the marketer has to identify an unfulfilled need or a gap in market which hasn't been fulfilled yet, and then develop a product or service or basically a value offering which can fulfill that need. So that is why identifying and meeting human and social needs. The basic essence of marketing here is identifying needs. Let us move to the examples. So I'm sure you must be familiar with both of the names, that is eBay and IKEA. So first of all, eBay is an online trading platform. So eBay recognized that there was a need for a platform where people can come and trade their products and buy and sell those products which were not available at other platforms. So the founders of eBay, they identified a gap. They identified that there was a need for a platform, for a trading platform. So they came up with an online auction clearing house. So they turned an unfulfilled need into a business venture. Now moving on to IKEA, we all know IKEA is a furnishing giant. So IKEA, they identified that people wanted inexpensive furniture. So in order to provide them with what people wanted, they came up with knockdown furniture and DIY furniture. Both the companies, eBay and IKEA, they turned unfulfilled needs into profitable business opportunities for themselves. So the simplest definition of marketing would be meeting the needs profitably. So after knowing about eBay and IKEA, I think you must be getting some idea about what marketing is. So now let us move to this scary looking definition. It's not scary, it's really easy to understand. Let us break it down and understand. So marketing is the activity or set of institutions and processes for creating, communicating, delivering and exchanging offerings that have value for customers, clients, partners or society at large. So basically this definition tells us nothing new. It tells us that there is a need which needs to be catered, and that need can be of anyone. It can be of customers, it can be of partners. Once a need is identified, and it can belong to anyone, any one of the following, be it customers, be it clients, be it partners or be it society at large. So once that need is identified, marketer needs to create a value offering that would fulfill that need, or that service would fulfill the need. That is why it would hold some value for the needy person. So we need to create a value offering to fulfill the market need. Once that value offering is created, we need to communicate it, deliver it and exchange it with the needy person. And that need, as I told you, can belong to any one of the following. So marketing is nothing new, but it is just creating, communicating and delivering and exchanging of offerings that have value for customers, clients, partners, society at large. So I hope now the scary definition is not scary to you anymore. Now moving on to social marketing. Social marketing, as the name in itself tells us, comprises of two words, social and marketing. Marketing, I just told you what is marketing. Now we can understand that here, in case of social marketing, the need must be belonging to society at large. So social marketing is nothing but using the principles of marketing to make the living standards of people better, improving the collective welfare of the society at large. So if a company gets involved in building a hospital with affordable medical treatment, or it gets involved in building a school with affordable education for poor children, they are improving the welfare of public at large and they are getting involved in social marketing. I know you must be familiar with Tesla. So Tesla, it entered into a venture which is called Hyperloop. So Hyperloop is a venture which is dedicated to resolving the problem of traffic and making a profitable business out of it. So Tesla is involved in building a venture which is called Hyperloop, and Hyperloop is nothing. It aims at solving traffic congestion at large. So as it aims towards solving problem of society at large, it comes under the purview of social marketing. Now marketing management. Marketing management is nothing but art and science. So how do we categorize anything as science or art? First, we need to know what is science and what is art. So science is a collective body of knowledge which is based on a set of principles which can be universal truths or which may be proved by experimentation. So marketing can be said to be science, as marketing also works on some models, some theories, some principles which have been proved with experimentation, and most of these principles are universally applicable. So that is why marketing can be categorized as science. Now what is art? Art is something which is creative, innovative, and does not cater to rules and regulations at large. So marketing is also an art because it works by observing human behavior, that how consumers behave, the motivation of their purchases. So marketers have to study the behavior of their targeted consumers, which is unpredictable, and since it is unpredictable, then you have to take measures for it which are creative and which do not follow a set of rules and regulations. That is why marketing also involves creativity, and since it involves creativity, it is art. Now moving on to features of marketing. So first of all, first feature says exchange is the basic essence of marketing. Now explaining this feature, I can say that marketing involves an exchange transaction between two parties. One party, which is the needy party, which has got an unfulfilled need, and the other party, which aims toward fulfilling that need and creating a profitable venture out of it. So there are two parties, first the needy and the other, which is aiming towards fulfilling that need. So you can see that there is an exchange transaction. The party which wants to fulfill the need would create a value offering and provide this value offering to the needy person. And since this has a value for the needy person, the needy person would also provide the other party with something which has something of value for them. In the business context, let us say there is a need for a shampoo for oily hair in market. So the company would develop a shampoo which caters to oily haired people and provide it to the consumer. And the consumer in turn would pay the monetary price of the shampoo to the company. So we can see there is an exchange transaction of goods. So shampoo is moving from company to the consumer and money is moving from the consumer to the company. So there is an exchange transaction. That is why it is said that exchange is the basic essence of marketing. Now, second, customer or consumer oriented. So marketing is consumer oriented. I just told you that marketing is nothing but identifying the needs and trying to fulfill it and creating a profitable venture out of it. So if you want to fulfill customer's need or a consumer's need, you first need to understand what they want. And for understanding what they want, the marketer would have to research about that consumer or customer and create a database and then analyze the important information to know various things about the customer. So that is why marketing is consumer or customer oriented. So that is why it is said that customer is the god of market. Next, the third feature says that marketing precedes and succeeds production. So this feature says that we cannot synonymously identify marketing and production. Marketing begins a lot earlier than production and ends a lot later than production. So marketing begins with the research about the customer, about the needs that they have got unfulfilled, and the value offering that the company needs to create to fulfill those needs. So, and then developing the product, and after that, collecting information about that product, doing pilot tests and all that. So basically, marketing precedes production in the sense that the marketer needs to collect information about the customers, and marketing succeeds production in the sense that once the transfer of value offering has taken place from the marketer to the consumer, then the work of marketer does not end there. The marketer has to take care that the product that the consumer is using or consuming is
that consumer happy with that product or not? If the consumer is dissatisfied, what are the steps that the marketer can take to improve in future? And providing them with after-sale services and keeping a check and monitoring their consumption patterns. So basically, that is why marketing precedes and succeeds production. The last feature of marketing is that marketing is goal-oriented, and the goal being profit maximization through customer satisfaction. Since marketer creates a profitable venture out of identifying the needs and fulfilling that needs for the consumer, that is why the goal of marketer is to maximize the satisfaction of customer. Once the customer is satisfied, then only the customer can result in a profitable venture for the marketer. That is why the basic goal of marketing is maximizing consumer satisfaction. Without focusing on consumer satisfaction, the marketer cannot maximize his or her profit. Now, what can be marketed? What are the commodities that can be marketed? First of all, goods. It is as simple as that. We see a plethora of ads on television of various goods being advertised. So they can be shampoos, soaps, biscuits, eateries, etc., etc. So you can put a lot of goods under this purview. Next, services. So services are being provided by people like lawyers, doctors, teachers, etc. So all these people are providing services, so they also need to market themselves. They also need to identify their target consumer and let them know that we are here for fulfilling your unfulfilled needs. So the services that are being provided by these service providers also needs to be marketed. Now, events can also be marketed. Events like food truck festival, Jaipur literature festival, Olympics, World Cup, they all need to be marketed. I think you must have seen Kabaddi League's promotion or promotional ads on television. So basically, they are promoting an event which is going to happen, which is going to take place in future. They are just trying to intrigue the consumers regarding that event. Next, experiences. So I have an amusement park near my house, which is called Adventure Island. I think most of you have heard about it, I don't know. But these sort of amusement parks, they provide the consumers with experience, with the thrill, which the consumer can enjoy and then come back to it again later. So if anyone of you have heard about Bhangad, like Bhangad has a sort of a horror story and horror touch associated with it. So people go there not just to look at the things, not just for sightseeing, they just go there for that horror experience they want to have. So basically, experiences can also be marketed. Persons. It's very important to market personalities, sports persons like Sachin Tendulkar, Virat Kohli, actors like Shah Rukh Khan, Amitabh Bachchan, Katrina Kaif. We all see they have their PR agencies which handle what news stories are being published about them, how many news stories they are being mentioned, what kind of movies are they doing, what kind of rumors are going about them in media. So basically, persons also need to be marketed to build or maintain a good image in the eyes of public. Places also need to be marketed. You all must be familiar with Gujarat's promotional ad that is being done by Amitabh Bachchan on television. So in order to promote or boost the tourism of many places, you see many ads on televisions that promote travelers, that excite travelers to visit that place and experience what that place offers. So Singapore's ads are also very famous. Properties. So these properties can be of two natures, be it real estate, be it financial properties like shares and bonds. So these things also need to be marketed. I'm sure you must have seen ads of mutual funds on television. So mutual funds belongs to this category, financial property. Mutual funds to sahi hai and all that. So these properties also needs to be marketed. Now organizations, various organizations, they do their ads, various NGOs like Goonj, they do their ads so that people can know about them, contribute to them and associate with them. Information can also be marketed. In the present times, I think the most important good or the most important commodity a person has is information. So information is also an essential good which can be marketed. So there were ads on television about tiger conservation. So these ads used to tell us about how many tigers are left in India. So they basically used to provide us with information that can lead us to think that what can we do about the situation. So in this case, information is being marketed. Ideas are being marketed. We can see ads about HIV protection. We can see ads about cancer prevention, no smoking. So these are the ideas that smoking is bad for your health. How can you prevent yourself from being affected by cancer, from being affected by HIV? So these are the ideas which are being marketed. So after knowing what things can be marketed, we can now further move to the scope of marketing. The scope of marketing comprises of all the activities that come under the purview of marketing. So first of all, what a marketer needs to do is study of consumers' needs and wants. We just studied how it is important to identify needs. Fulfilling of needs is the basic objective of marketing. So for identifying those needs, a marketer needs to study consumers, their needs, their wants, what kind of products and services do they desire, what range of products do they want. So that is why marketing precedes production, and the marketer needs to identify the needs by studying about the consumer. So once needs and wants are analyzed, the marketer can move to the next step, which is study about the consumer behavior. So what are the factors that motivate purchase by consumers? What are the factors that disincentivize a consumer to not purchase a thing? So basically, when you understand about consumers, you can categorize them in different categories and then cater to their various needs. So categorization helps the companies to identify what kind of customers they should aim at. So we will read about this categorization, which is called segmentation and targeting, in further lectures of this marketing subject. Next, after analyzing consumer needs and behavior, the marketer has to move to product planning and development. So product planning includes everything from deciding the idea about the product to the actual production of the product. So here the marketer takes a decision like product research. They do research, what products are available in market now, do they satisfy consumers' need, is there anything else they want, what kind of range, what kind of colors of products they want. So all those things are being decided by the marketer at this level. So after deciding everything about the product, and once the product is ready, the value offering is ready, it needs to be branded. So it needs to be associated with the brand, with the company that is manufacturing it. And the basic idea behind branding is to popularize the product among the target audience. So you have prepared a product, but how would the consumer know about it? You need to communicate to the consumer that yes, we have got a product that can satisfy your needs. After branding, we come to packaging. So packaging is nothing but just providing a cover or a package or a sort of protection layer to the product before handling it to consumer. So it can act as a promotional tool. You can make the labels, the package really bright or really useful for the consumer so that the consumer gets intrigued by that product. So it fulfills various objectives like safety of the product, attraction, ease of use, transportation. So when we use our toothpaste, it comes with a rotating cap. We can use it and then put the cap back and then use it the next day. So if it was not that way, it would be really difficult to store it, to use it every day. So that package serves as a useful tool for the consumer. Next, after packaging, we move to channels of distribution. So the company, the marketer has to decide what kind of channels do they want to use. Do they want to go to the consumer directly, or they want to use a zero level channel or a one level channel, or they want to use internet like brands like Myntra, which sell online. So marketer has to make the decisions about channels of distribution and how do they want to reach to the consumer. So you have got a product that would satisfy consumer's need. You need to transfer that product. You need that product to reach the consumer. So here in this step, this decision is taken that how and what medium would be used to reach the consumer. Next, pricing. So it is very, very, very important to price the product appropriately. It should be in the affordability range of the consumer and it should be much enough that it satisfies the objectives of the company. So pricing is really important. It depends on various factors like the level of competition in the market, product life cycle, marketing goals and objectives. So pricing is very important for the product as this is the major factor which would affect the buying capability of the consumer. After pricing, sales management. So now, till here, the marketer has decided everything about the product. The product is being made, the product is being branded, packaged, distributed and priced properly. But now, it needs to be sold to the consumer. So now, decisions have to be taken regarding how to reach the consumer and then how to persuade that consumer to buy this particular product or service. Next, promotion. So promotion is one of the essential activity of marketing because it is not enough to produce a product that would satisfy consumer needs. It is very important to let the consumer know about the product, to make the consumer aware about the product. So promotion is that stage where the company would decide how we are going to let the consumer know about our product. How are we going to transfer the information? How are we going to communicate to the consumer? The promotion, the next activity comes finance. So all these activities till now, they come with a budget. The company decides budget for every single activity so that they don't go out of pocket for producing the product or for packaging the product, for promoting the product. So basically a budget has to be decided for everything that the product has to be produced within this range. The promotional budget would be this. This would be the distribution budget. So a budget has to be fixed and followed for every activity. So till now, the product has been made, it has been branded, labeled and packaged and transferred to the consumer. But after the product is transferred to the consumer, the work of marketer does not end here. There are after-sales services which the marketer needs to manage. So once the consumer is consuming the product, the marketer needs to know whether the consumer is satisfied or not satisfied with the product. If the consumer is not satisfied, the marketer needs to analyze the reasons behind it and improve those mistakes. So basically providing the customer with all the after-sales services, with all the information that the consumer needs to use the product, in helping in repair and maintenance of the product, so that the marketer has to look after. So till now we have learned about what is marketing, social marketing, marketing management, how does marketing pose as an art and science, scope of marketing, and what are the things that can be marketed and the features of marketing. So after learning this much about marketing, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. If you subscribe to it, then you're gonna get updates of all these videos, which would be useful to you in various exams. Thank you.